Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much to those who've stayed tuned with me. We are back with another session of building self-confidence and personal development. I'm just going to read a few comments that I've been receiving from my videos and I look forward to sharing it with you now. So the first one is, I was watching your videos in regards to building self-confidence and personal development and I have been struggling with it since the start of the year, but it's great to hear some of your practical tips. And I absolutely love your inspirational videos. Very inspiring and motivational. And someone said, I found it helpful to try to be a better person than I was yesterday. Even if it's just a tiny bit better, that's progress. Thanks for the video. I've been really humbled to know that people are actually watching, knowingly and unknowingly behind the scenes. And I always say this to people that you don't know who is watching you. Whether people tell you or not, you are making progress. You have to always say that to yourself every single day. Although Authentic Worth is having their first event on Saturday, the 14th of March, we do not just want you to come and have confidence for a day. We want you to apply everything that has been taught from myself and from the two guest speakers on how to build confidence and personal development every day. How you choose to make your day is up to you. You are responsible for building your own self-confidence and personal development. No one can tell you how to be confident. Nobody can teach you how to love yourself. You have to embrace who you are, work with your flaws, work with your insecurities. Let them be the turnaround point where you say, enough is enough. I need to use my weaknesses and turn them around into strengths. Self-confidence and personal development works hand in hand. You need people and people need you. At some point, you're going to have to learn how to work with people in a team, in projects, whether that be in university, building a business, share knowledge with each other, build upon each other. If you've got one strength and your neighbor has a weakness, build upon their weakness and let them learn from your strength. Self-confidence is daily and it takes time. Even those who are still striving for perfection and making it to success, they still have a long way to go to be confident. Have you been able to identify what you're good at and what you're not good at? Have you been able to sit down and think about what steps you can take to be confident? Step one, always admit that you are in need. Don't see it as a sign of insecurity. Saying that you need help is the first way of identifying and building your self-confidence. The way you dress can actually build upon your confidence. I worked in retail for 6 years in Dorothy Perkins. When I finished my role after university, I really had a good dress sense. I remember when I was in secondary school, my dress sense was, yeah. I'm not showing any pictures, guys. If you want to come and see them, I won't show you. How does dressing come into this? The way you dress makes you feel good. Who remembers color blocking? I do. I used to wear really bright colors and I still do now because my personality just oozes brightness and enthusiasm. But I really love wearing bright colors, especially colors such as orange and pink or mustard and orange. If you really combine those colors together, you will see how amazing they look. In one of my lookbook videos, I put really bright colors together. I'll insert the video for you to see it actually. When you want to build self-confidence, it's not necessarily about buying new clothes, but it's also about looking at what you have in your wardrobe and making it work for you. How you dress is the way you're going to be addressed. Think positively as well. I cannot emphasize enough on how important it is to have a positive mindset. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. If you are always in a situation and a state where you are receiving bad news and you're always down about it, but you're not thinking about what good have I learned from this situation, you will not grow. For every rejection, for every loss, for every tear, for every temporary moment, and I use that word so gracefully, temporary, because your pain is only for a temporal moment. Learn how to place your negative thoughts with positive ones. You may not have the skills to write a book, but if you just pick up that pen and grab that paper and start writing, you will realize that it will turn into a book. And that's what happened to me. I remember when I finished university, I started journaling and I didn't know it was going to be a book, but I thought that my passion for writing is expanding. So let me now turn it into a blog. Now I've turned it into a blog. It's now a website and now books. And who would ever think that had I not touched that pen in 2012 and started writing? You don't realize what you have within you until you start changing your negative thoughts into positive ones. The next step is to kill negative thoughts. I cannot emphasize enough on how much your thoughts run your mind, and you may not realize it, but what you think about now is going to follow you each and every step of the way. I'm not going to make it. I know I'm going to fail. I've waited for this to come all my life and it's still delaying. The more you're saying these things, the more you're delaying yourself, or people around you don't want you to do well. No, it's you. You are responsible for what goes into your mind and what comes out of your mind. When your mindset is negative, of course your words are going to be negative. Respect is a two-way relationship. When your thoughts are positive, your thoughts are going to throw back positivity to you. You cannot expect to reap a harvest if you're sowing little or you're not sowing anything at all, or all you're sowing is, it's not going to grow. I've waited for 10 years. Nothing is happening. Keep waiting. No matter how long the delay is, remember, delay is not denial, and you will surely get what you ask for as long as you kill negative thoughts. Get to know yourself. Whether you're an introvert or an extrovert, you need time for yourself. And not just time sparingly, but quality time where you're not distracted by anything or anyone. Social media is locked off. Your phone is locked off. Your laptop is locked off. Friends and family are also locked off. You need time for you to reflect. Being away from your environment is also a great way to know who you are and to learn about yourself. There could be so much opportunity out there that you're not realizing it because you're so comfortable in your situation. Being complacent isn't attractive. Make sure you get to know yourself. Build upon your heart. Build upon your character. Build upon your attitude. If you have an attitude problem, stay away from people so that you don't rub that negative attitude onto them. Because remember, I'll keep saying this, you don't know what anyone is going through. So be very cautious and learn to work on your own self daily. Be kind and generous. I can strongly guarantee you, when you are a kind person, you will attract the right people. Unfortunately, yes, you might attract people that will take advantage of you, but regardless of whether they do, it is your kindness that will put a stop to their bad behavior. I see myself as someone that can get along with people easily, and I love to give compliments out. What you said to that person has made their day without you realizing it. Remember, being kind makes you feel good about yourself. Speak slowly. This is so important. And I'm laughing actually because in my head anyway, but I feel like I speak so fast. I'm just used to it. But I've realized that when you actually speak slow, people can get you more easily.
Now, I'm not saying that you have to speak this slow, but I believe that you can tell that when I do speak slow, it is more understandable.
Whereas when I speak the way I speak now, I'm sure the majority can understand what I'm saying. Not everyone's pace of learning is going to be the same. Some people may need you to speak slower than others, whereas other people can speak really fast and they get it straight away. The most important thing is that you can speak slowly so that people understand you. When you rush and speak at the same time, that does bring about nerves. And I've been there. I remember going to events and the organizer would say, I want you to stand up, say your name, why you're here and where you came from. You will see everyone's hearts doing du-dum, du-dum, du-dum. When you want to build self-confidence, you have to come out of your comfort zone. So when they ask you, what is your name, where you've come from, what do you want to gain from this event? Speak freely, just three simple questions in one go, maybe 10 to 15 seconds each. Stand on your own two feet. Building self-confidence and personal development will really expose you to situations and times in your life where it will feel like you are alone. And when that happens, you have no other choice than to stand firm. Remember, you've got the power to stand tall. Set a small goal and achieve it. A small goal could be to even eat healthy or change your diet. Another goal could be to learn how to manage your money and budget. No matter how small or insignificant the goal may sound, a goal is a goal. It does not matter at all how big or small it is. And remember, the key ingredient is consistency. Your ultimate goal should be to become the best version of yourself. I also want to give this last tip in terms of building self-confidence and personal development. It is to Smile. I feel so much better when I smile. Smiling is such a great attribute to those around you, but more importantly to yourself. When you're feeling really low, look in the mirror and smile. You will feel so much better. But do it often. I hope that you really enjoyed those few tips on how to build self-confidence and personal development. I cannot emphasize how much these videos do not even touch the surface of what we will be providing on Saturday, the 14th of March, 2020. Do not delay. Reserve yours today. Thank you guys for watching my video. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please do. If you want to be seeing more videos like this, don't forget to click on the notification bell as well, where all the videos will be sent to your email exclusively by Esther NJ. Remember, you've got the power. I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Bye.